Hi everyone, Amanda here.
Hi, and I'm Kate.
Welcome
to the National Museum of Australia for today's Fun at Home activity.
Pretty excited about today, Kate, because we seem to have a lot of stars around.
That's right, we're going to be looking at the stars today with our Indigenous curator, Shona.
I'm not going to make it today, so say hello to Shona for me, but I'll see you at the end. So it's goodbye from me. Should we count to three and get you in?
Let's do it.
One, two, three.
Welcome back, Shona. So we're here in the exhibition.
That's right. This is the exhibition of the Endeavour Voyage, the untold story of Cook and the first Australians.
And so before we begin, would you like to do an acknowledgement of country for us?
Absolutely. We would all like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of the lands that we meet on here today, the Ngunnawal, the Ngunnawal and the Ngambri people.
Thank you, Shona. Okay, shall we look at the stars today?
Absolutely. I've got a couple of great stories for you. Let's go check it out.
Let's. Okay, Shona, so what do we have here?
We have two telescopes here, and I know they look really old, Kate, but actually, these were the height of technology in 1770.
So can you tell us, what would they be used for?
Well, these particular telescopes were actually specifically developed to record or see through a long distance away. But this one here at the top was actually really good in the day or in the night.
It's terrific. So imagine being Cook and his crew on these voyages and going on these vast adventures using these actual telescopes.
They're amazing. Pretty amazing, aren't they?
Yeah. Let's go and have a look at another object. Have you looked up at the stars at night? We've got some stars here in our exhibition.
That's right. The stars play such an important part in this story. When Cook was using them to navigate, Indigenous people were using the dark matter between the stars to actually talk about the different seasons. But for the most part, we've got this beautiful skyline that also shows the emu.
Thanks, Shona. That was really interesting. You might like to go and have a look at home up at the night sky and see if you can see the emu up there. But now let's go and have a look at another object. Okay, Shona, so what do we have here?
This is a fantastic piece. It's actually a headdress that was made by Milton Savage from Horn Island, and he's part of the Carrareg mob.
And I bet this has a great story.
Do you know what? This actual headdress is packed with stories. Not only is it part of a headpiece that you would wear when you dance, but it also tells about the constellation of the stars.
And does it relate to an animal as well?
You are so right. Actually, if you traced around the outside of the stars, you would actually see that it forms the shape of a shark.
That's fantastic. And so Indigenous people using this for navigation?
Absolutely. When the stars or the nose of the shark is down, it means that it's low tide. But when the nose is up, it means that it's high tide.
Thanks, Shona. That's fascinating information. We might go and make some star-inspired artwork now with Amanda. We'll see you guys later.
Bye for now.
Bye.
Hi, Kate.
Hi, Amanda. What are you up to? Are you looking at the stars?
Yes. I was so inspired by what you and Shona were talking about. I've made myself a little telescope and I'm looking at the night skies.
Well, I thought we might make some starry nights.
Great idea.
With a bit of paint and some pastels. Shall we get started?
So how do we do this, Kate? We need paint?
We do need paint, need some blank paper and some lovely coloured oil pastels.
Yeah, so the oilier they are, the better they work.
Very much. And something to scrape back the paint once it's dry.
That's really cool, Kate. Have you got an example that you might have already made?
I haven't. Here's a smaller version I did earlier. So you can see the coloured crayons coming through once the paint has been scratched back. We've got a starry night sky with a ship.
Beautiful. So is it important to cover the whole page?
It is. You want to get every spot.
And get it really thick. So Kate, once we've covered the page, what happens next?
Well, we're going to paint it. Here we go. So we get this beautiful black paint here and we just layer it on thick over the top of the pastels.
And I think I know what you're going to say next. Once you've covered the page, you have to let the paint dry.
Very true. So you might want to come back to it a bit later before you get to the next stage.
And Kate, is that just acrylic paint?
It is.
And quite thick. So don't put too much water in it.
Once we've finished painting, we let it dry. Now I haven't completed that, but that's because I've got one dry already over here. make sure it's nice and dry, and then what we're going to do is we're going to scratch away the paint and see the colours come up behind. Amanda, could you pass my tool?
There's a few here, Kate. This one's nice and sharp. You can look around at home and see what you've got. A knife, a coin could work, a stick. These are really cool. They're like little sharp bamboo sticks. There's a few for Kate. Okay.
So we've got a bit of a moon starting. Might put some stars in the sky. And it should come away nice and easily. If you paint nice and thick, you get lovely effects with the colours coming through there. We have got some other ways you can draw night skies.
I've got an idea, Kate.
Yeah.
I've got this bit of black paper here. Now, if you didn't have time to get the paint out, or if you didn't have waxy crayons, you can literally find a bit of black card, get some pencils, I've got a white one somewhere, and draw on your paper. You could draw little stars, some great big ones, or if you didn't even have any pencils, you could find some stickers. This is a really easy one. Or you could do a combination of both. We're going to keep working here and finish our starry artwork. Thanks everyone.
Thank you.
Bye.
See ya.
I quite like the stickers.